Good morning, students. How are you all? Today I am going to tell you, students, regarding the numericals concerned with P&L appropriation from your NCERT book. As we have discussed already regarding the concepts and applications, and we have also solved the question number 5 from NCERT. Today we are dealing with question number 7. Have a look. So, students, today we are going to solve the P&L appropriation account, NCERT textbook question number 7. In this question, you can see there are two partners, Manish and Girish. They share the profit equally. Second, Manish will get the salary 400 per month. So we have to convert it into year. So 400 into 12, because it is in month, we have to convert into annually per annum. So 4800 will be there. So 400 into 12 is equal to 4800 rupees. Girish, who manages the sales department, Girish is one of the partner who manages the sales department. He will be allowing a salary commission 10% of net profit. So Girish will get the commission 10% of net profit after allowing Manish salary. So in the question, net profit, in last line you can see the net profit during the year is amounting 40,000. So after deducting Manish salary from net profit, 40,000, I have written 40,000 minus 4800, because Manish salary is how much? 4800. 40,000 is net profit minus 4800, you will get 35,200. That is the net profit after allowing Manish salary. On this 35,200, we have to calculate the commission of Mr. Girish. So 35,200 into 10%. 4.7% interest on capital is to be allowed, and 5.5% interest on drawing, concerned with interest on drawing. Fixed capital of both the partner is given 1,80,000. Annual drawing is also mentioned. So now how to attempt the question. So first item, that is the net profit, is given. So I have made the pro forma of profit and loss appropriation accounting for partnership firm concerned P&L appropriation account, particular amount. So first item, that is profit and loss account, that is net profit. The amount is given in the question is 40,000. How much? 40,000. So I am writing 40,000 over here. Now in the question, you can see two things. Manish is getting salary. So Manish salary, that is 4800. How? 400 rupees into 12. Now I have written the Manish salary, that is 4800. And Girish has to get commission. How much? That is 40,000. That is 40,000 after Manish salary, it will be 35,200. So 35,200 into how much? 10%. That will be the commission, 3520. Means 3520. That is the commission of Girish concerned. So students, as we have seen, we have to put the 2 and by also. Now in case of 4.7% interest on capital, we have to charge. So 2 interest on capital for Manish and for Girish. So the capital of Manish is 1 lakh and capital of Girish is 80,000. So 7%, 1 lakh 7% is, to 1 lakh ka 7% hume calculate karna padega, that is 7,000. And in the same manner, Girish we have to calculate and we will get 7,000 and this one. So total amount is 12,600. In the same manner, we have to calculate drawing also. So interest on drawing is concerned to credit side of P&L appropriation. So 5% interest on drawing has to be charged. So interest on drawing given to the partner, that is concerned to given by the partner to the firm, that is that will become the income for the firm. So Manish and Girish, again, so Manish and Girish, so interest on drawing will be 800 and 700. So students, after getting 1500, we have to total it up on both the side. Here we will get 41,500. As you can see, 40,000 plus 1500, we will get 41,500. Here total we should get 41,500. So 4800 plus 3520 plus 12,600. So the difference amount we have to write here means we should get this much, and there is a difference of 20,580. How? This minus this minus this minus this, we will get this 20,580, and this is the profit which is transferred to the partner's capital account, and this profit has to be transferred into capital account in which ratio? As mentioned in the question, profit will be shared equally, so in equal ratio. So I will write to profit transfer to Manish and Girish, that is 10,290. So we will get 20,580, as you can see, students. So today we have solved question number 7. In previous so students, you have seen the question number 7, how to approach the question and how to attempt the question. So please solve question number 4 and question number 6 from your NCERT book as a practice work. Thank you, students.